Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and today I'm sharing the 10 cards that I made using the Simon Says Stamp Make Card Kit. So first let's take a quick look on what's inside the kit. So first of all you get this glue pen which has a nice fine tip. You also get this package with stickers and you get tons of stickers and they are also great for using them in your scrapbooking or project life or even mixed media projects. You also get all those colorful sequins, an adorable clear stamp set that is called Happy Day, and of course you get a pack of 6x6 pattern papers. These are actually by Lone Phone and you get tons of plate pattern papers and also the coordinating cardstock. There are 5 different colors which I am going to start and cut them out, fold them, and create my card bases, just like I always do on those 10 cards. So I'm going to cut them in half, fold them, and there I get 2 from each color, so there are 10 card bases in total, which I am going to decorate. So let's get started with card number 1. I have used my favorite stitched rectangle die and I have cut out a piece out of white cardstock. And I'm going to also stamp the cloud on just a scrap piece of paper. Now I am also going to stamp the kite on this beautiful pattern paper. And just because I don't want to have that face on the kite, I'm going to stamp at the back since I only need the basic shape. So I'm going to use my scissors, cut out the kite and flip it on my card. Now for the cloud, I'm going to use my scissors to cut it out, but I am not planning to use the cloud on the card. Instead, I'm going to use it as a mask to create my background. So I'm using my blending tool and my distressing, and that's tumbled glass. And as you can see, I am creating kind of a background by moving the cloud all over the white cardstock and applying just a little bit of ink. So I get a nice soft sky for my kites. And now I can go ahead and stamp the kite directly on my paper. I'm going to stamp it twice. And then I'm going to stick down the pattern paper. For the little bows, I am going to use my Spectrum Noir markers. You can use any alcohol markers that you have at this stage and just color in the bows. I have chosen 2 coordinating colors. And now it's time to prepare my sentiment. I am using one that says Thinking of You, which comes from the clear stamp set in the kit. I have stamped it with Versamark ink on black cardstock. Cut it out and I'm going to stick it down with foam squares at the back. These are going to add a little bit of dimension. So now that my main panel is ready, I'm going to stick it on my light blue cardstock and my card is ready. To finish it off, I am going to use a little bit of clear Wink of Stella glitter pen on the kites. Nice and simple. So let's move on to card number 2. From the leftover that I have from the previous card, I have cut out this panel and I am going to use this die by Hero Arts and I'm going to cut out a tag. I am going to use this masking paper and I'm going to stamp the apple on top. When I am trying to make 10 cards out of one card kit, I always try to keep my cards quite simple and quick to make. And this way I make sure that I don't use up too many of the products, the supplies that come in the kit. So I'm using my scissors to cut out this apple and I'm going to stamp using black ink directly this apple on my tag. And now I'm going to use my apple, that is a mask, to do some masking technique so that some of the apples appear as if they are at the back. And as I am doing my masking, just to let you all know that you can find the full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below the video in the description area, as well as on my blog. And if you are wondering where I got my beautiful ring, I want to let you all know that this is a handmade ring that my friend Katerina made. And I am also going to add a link down below to her website if you want to check out her beautiful creations. Now you can see I was too lazy to cut out a second masking, and I just used the paper that I have peeled off for my mask. So anyway, at this stage you can always use your favorite coloring technique. It can be your alcohol markers, it can be your watercoloring. I decided to use my Prismacolor pencil since I find them really easy and quick to use. So I'm applying some green on some of the apples, and I'm going to leave only the one in the center, which I am going to color red. For this card, I am going to go with a sentiment from the stamp set that says, "You are one of a kind." So I got the inspiration from that sentiment and decided to have a bunch of green apples and only one red that stands out. I am also stamping the speech bubble from the set, and I am going to stamp inside the sentiment. And next I am going to use my scissors to cut out the speech bubble, and I am going to stick it on the tag using a foam square at the back, as if one of the apples is saying that. Now when I am making these cards, I usually cheat a little bit, and I use a couple of extra white cardstocks. And of course a few of my favorite dies, such as the rectangle dies, this die that cuts out the tag, as well as some that cut out borders, you will see later on when I'll use them. So now I have used my crocodile to set an eyelet at the top. I'm threading some string. And now I'm going to stick that on top of my panel. I think that pattern paper is so beautiful, and I really love the colors. So now I'm going to stick that on top of one of the card bases. To secure the string so that it stays exactly where I want to, I am using a couple of tiny glue dots. And as always, to finish off the card, I am going to use my Wink of Stella clear glitter pen on the red apple. You know I love my stitch rectangle dies, so I have done it again. I have cut out a panel, and now I am going to stamp the sun. I'm using black ink to stamp the sun, and I'm also going to stamp the cloud. I have actually stamped the cloud without stamping the face that's inside, and I have done it this three times, so I will end up with three clouds at the end. I'm using my scissors to cut it out, and now on the main panel I'm using my blending tool and apply a little bit of tumbled glass. And you will see that I mainly stay heavy with ink at the bottom of the panel, and as I go at the top it gets lighter and lighter. Now I have searched for a die that cuts out the exact shape of the sun, so I am going to make a hole right in the center. You can punch it out, or if you have a die you can do that, or even you can use your scissors. I'm using my Spectrum Noir markers again, coloring the sun, what's left of it anyway, and you probably get it by now, I'm going for a window card. At the back I'm adding a little bit of tape adhesive, and I'm going to stick this acetate, and now I'm going to make the backing of my window card using fan foam. Using fan foam for the back of window cards makes the process really quick and easy, and all you need to make sure is to add an adhesive that really holds. So I'm going to add some of the sequins that were in the kit, and I really love all those rainbow colors. And to cover up the window, I am just cutting out a little piece from another pattern paper. So my window is ready now. Now it's time to assemble the card. I am going to stick down the three clouds, and to do so I am using some foam adhesive at the back of the clouds. So I'm going to add three of the clouds, one at the very bottom and two close to the sun. I'm going to use my scissors to cut out all the excess, and my card is pretty much finished. All that's left to do is to stick some of those stickers here and there. So I'm just going to stick that on my white cardstock and finish it off as always with a clear Wing of Stella glitter pen. So let's move on to the next card. This is a piece of watercolor paper, which is quite thick. I'm going to link the exact one that I'm using down below. And I'm going to do the smoosh technique, which is really fun and you cannot go wrong with it. You always get great results. On my stamping block, I have applied a little bit of tumbled grass by Tim Holtz and I have sprayed some water. And with a plastic packaging, I'm just moving some of those splashes from the block to my card. You have to try it yourself and you will find that with that plastic packaging, you can really control where those splashes are going. I am using my heat gun to make sure that everything is nice and dry, and then all I have to do is to stamp my focal point. So for that I am going to stamp the umbrella on a leftover that I have from a previous card. You see I'm really frugal with my supplies here. I'm going to cut it out with my scissors and I'm going to paper piece it on my main panel. For my backing paper, I have chosen this plate blue pattern paper, which I am going to cut out to be the standard size of a card, so that's 4.25 by 5.5. I'm going to stick the panel on top at the center, but before I need to stamp the umbrella directly with black ink. I'm pressing hard just because this is watercolor paper, so that I get a good impression. I'm going to use my glue pen from the kit to stick down my paper. Also notice that on the umbrella, in the stamp, there is a face, but I chosen not to stamp it. You can do whatever you like. I am using a thin black marker to color the handle of the umbrella, and just like I did before, I am stamping, I did white emboss the sentiment. For the sentiment, I went with one that was in the kit that said, "Showered with love." So I have sponged out a few red hearts, which I am going to stick on top of the umbrella as if they are falling there. With my tool, I'm just trying to decide where all those little hearts are going to go. And once I'm happy with the placement, I can use my glue pen and stick them down. To finish it off, I just had to use my clear Wing of Stella glitter pen over those little hearts. And finally, I'm using some tape adhesive to stick that panel on top of my card base. And my card is ready. And now for a really easy card. I just love this pattern paper. I can use tons of it again and again. So anyway, I have decided to cut this in a panel that is slightly smaller than a standard card. And I'm also using this border die that cuts out a speech bubble. For my sentiment, I'm going to use stamps from another set, and that's because all the sentiments in this set are really, really tiny to fit that tiny speech bubble that was in the set. So you can use any stamps that you have really. I have picked a couple of Simon Says stamp ink pads that coordinate with my pattern paper. So I went with Sunshine and Jelly Bean. And I'm just using my sentiment there. Actually, I have two parts for the sentiment. One that says sending you lots of, which I am actually stamping with Jelly Bean, and hugs, which I have stamped with Sunshine. But you can recreate the same design and pretty much stamp whatever you have. To accent the card even more and make it more interesting, I decided to stick down some of the sequins from the kit. I'm using gel medium to stick them down. And that is finishing the card. It's super quick and easy. For this card, I'm using this border die, and I really believe that a good set of border dies is a great investment if you are a card maker, since you can go back to them again and again. You see that I keep using again and again the same dies in all of my 10 cards videos. I am going to stick those pieces of paper on my directly on my card base, and I have used a foam tape at the back just to add a little bit of dimension. And you can see how adding that white border underneath my pattern paper really helps the pattern paper to pop even more from the card base. So all I have to do now is to stick a bunch of stickers. Really quick card, but I really believe that this is so cute with that beautiful pattern paper. It really makes the card, and how this pattern paper coordinates with the green card base. Just to embellish it a little bit more, I decided to add a bow. So with my crocodile, I made a hole at the top. I'm going to cut a piece of string and I'm going to thread it through that hole. I'm going to thread it twice and then tie a bow. As always, there is a giveaway on my blog, so for a chance to win this card kit by Simon Says Stamp, make sure to visit my blog and enter your details. I like the tails of the bow to be nice and long. So my card is pretty much finished, I just need to tie it up a little bit, that string. And let's move on to the next card. So here is another quick and simple card. I have used my rectangle dies to cut out a frame. And on a white cardstock, I am going to stamp at the center of the panel this kite. I have cut out already a piece of pattern paper, which I'm going to stick on top of the kite. And this pattern paper actually fits inside the frame exactly. On the frame at the back, I have added some foam tape, and I'm going to stick it directly on my card base. So now I can add a little bit of tape adhesive at the back of my white panel and just place it inside that frame. So the frame is actually raised a little bit. I'm using one of the sentiments from the sticker, and just because I want this to be raised, I am adding a little bit of my embossing tool at the back, a little bit of powder, so it's not sticky anymore, and I can use now some tiny foam squares. So the sentiment is actually raised now. Although the design is pretty easy and it's not very complicated, adding a little bit of dimension like the raised border and the raised sentiment really makes it interesting. Also, a great way to embellish your card is to add some shine, or just like I am doing here, you can add glossy accents. I am going to cover up the whole kite, which is going to give a nice finished look. Just like always, at the end of the video, you will be able to see close-up photos of all the cards that I made today. And also you can see photos of the cards on my blog. So now let's move on to card number 8. For this card, I am going to white emboss the sun on a piece of yellow cardstock. This cardstock was not included in the kit, I am cheating now. So anyway, I am applying a little bit of white powder, and that was Wow embossing powder, the bright white one. I'm using my scissors to cut out the sun, and I'm going to add for the cheeks of the sun a couple of pink sequins. These were from the kit. Again, I'm using my gel medium to stick the cheeks down, and I think that the sun looks really cute like that. So now I am going to add a little bit of foam squares at the back of this pattern paper panel. And this was actually a leftover from the previous card when I cut out that frame. So now I'm going to add a little bit of interest on my card, just because again this is a very simple design. It's always nice to add little things to make them interesting. So I'm adding a wobble, which is a string that is going to make the sun pop. Just because that was kind of bigger than the sun, I used my scissors to cut it out to size. And I'm going to stick the bottom sticker on my card. So you can see that even the simplest of card designs can be interesting by adding little bits and pieces, like a little bit of glossy accents or a wobble. For my sentiment, I used one of the stickers and my card was done. For this card, I am going to do a lot of embossing, so I am going to stamp the apple by using Versamark ink directly on my card base. As I am stamping the apple, I am making sure that I turn it in different angles so that my background is getting more interesting. I am going to cover up the whole background, and once that's ready, I am going to apply some white embossing powder. Again, I like to use the bright white embossing powder by WOW. Once that's there and I have a nice background, I have used my heat gun to heat set the embossing powder, and again I'm doing a little bit of embossing. I have stamped the apple again on green pattern paper and on red pattern paper. I'm going to heat set them and then use my scissors to cut them out. And on this card I have cheated a little bit, so the cardstock, the red cardstock and the dark green for the leaf were not included in the kit. I am using some foam squares at the back of the apple and I'm going to stick it on top of one of the apples that I have already stamped. So the card is pretty much finished. I am going to stamp the speech bubble from the set. And on the inside of the speech bubble, I am going for the tiny sentiment that says "World's best teacher." I'm going to use my scissors to cut out the speech bubble, and again with a foam square at the back, I'm going to stick it on my card. You can call this card finished, or you can take it a step further, like I did here. I'm going to add some glitter with my Clear Wink of Stella glitter pen, and then I am going to cover the apple by using my glossy accents. It really gives a beautiful effect, and you will see that it kind of traps the glitter inside. And finally, for the last card, I am going to create a window card. I have made window cards way too many times, so I'm using the same techniques here. Added inside the sequence, peeling off the backing, and I'm going to stick the pattern paper to cover up the window. I'm going to stick the window directly on top of my card base by using tape adhesive. For the sentiment, you can use a sticker from the stickers that were included in the kit, or you can use any word die that you have in your stash, like a hello or a happy birthday, a congratulations, whatever you like. I went with this big hello, which I'm going to stick directly on the window. So I'm going to use my glue pen at the back, apply a little bit of glue, and then stick it down. And that finishes the last card for today, so let's take a look at all the cards together and also see the leftovers that I have. So here are all the cards. I really love the plate pattern paper by Lone Fawn, and I think that it really made the cards. Beautiful spring colors and really clean and easy to replicate designs. Now I'm going to put those aside and I'm going to bring in the kit so we can see what I have left off. So I have the glue pen, quite a few of the sequins, of course the stamp set, lots and lots of stickers for many more cards and projects, and I have lots of 6x6 pattern papers left. They are actually 11 left. And here are some close-up photos of all the cards that I made today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. And if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel already, make sure to do so, because this is the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more videos where I am creating 10 cards using the Simon Says Stamp card kit. Thank you all for watching.